Today is the topic we are discussing about transition diagram for recognition of tokens, reserved words, identifiers, and white spaces, digits. The title which is given in your syllabus is this. In addition to that, we are discussing transition diagram in order to understand the white space, in order to recognize digits also, digits as well. Now I ask the question, what is a transition diagram? Have you ever heard of this? What is the meaning of transition diagram? Any one of you can text me, or you can unmute yourself and you can answer to me. What is the meaning of transition diagram? You have completed just now formal languages and automata theory. Then you must be knowing, every one of you, even the person who is irregular to the institution also must know. Anyone could answer what is the meaning of transition diagram? Could you hear me? Transition diagram, could you able to answer for? What is a transition diagram? No one is ready to answer? Or don't know the answer? Guys, come on, you may need to be open. Pavan Teja?
Ma'am.
Are you there? Yeah.
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
What is the meaning of transition diagram?
It's a pictorial representation showing the flow, how the process goes.
You may be using the slide and answering. In simple term, it is finite automata.
Yeah,
so
yes,
you would have studied one unit, full of one unit at least, I hope so. You would have studied non-deterministic finite automata, general finite automaton we used to call, then finite automaton classified into non-deterministic finite automaton, determinate finite automaton, non-deterministic finite automaton further classified into two different category, non-deterministic finite automaton with epsilon, non-deterministic finite automaton without epsilon. These are all the basic categorization of finite automata or classification of finite automata. That's fine. When it comes to compiler design, we are not going to solve problems like formal languages. We will be discussing only to the context required for construction of the compiler or language translator. So construction of the compiler components or compiler design, these are all those concepts we'll be considering when it comes to compiler design. So that here they are labeling it as transition diagram. Then the moment we say here transition diagram, it must be deterministic. What is the meaning of deterministic? There is no ambiguity in decision making. Yeah, exact difference between NFA and DFA is NFA will have lot of ambiguity, or at least one ambiguity in one circumstance. There are two types, NFA and DFA. Whereas DFA, it will take deterministic decision. One point at a time, being in the circle, every circle, it will lead to one decision, only one transition, exact transition it will determine. So that is called DFA. The same DFA we are terming in terms of transition diagram when it comes to compiler design. It's a kind of flow chart. So whenever we are connecting two different components or multiple components together in a logical sequence, it's termed as flow chart. It doesn't matter whether you are using like a first year language flow chart or it is a transition diagram. This is useful for lecture. This diagram is similar to a flow chart. It is useful in lecture or lexical analysis. So it's possible to draw a transition diagram for each token. What is the meaning of token? Operator is one of the token. Within the operator, you will be having set of operators like arithmetic operator, relational operator, logical operator, bitwise operator, special operators, punctuation operator, something like that. You will be having other operators. So for every operator, you will be having here transition diagram. So every operator means not looking at one operator at a time. Under that category, under that arithmetic operator, it's an umbrella-like domain. Within that umbrella-like domain, you will be having set of operators. In order to recognize arithmetic operators, you will have only one transition diagram. In order to recognize all the relational operators, you will have only one transition diagram. In order to recognize all the logical operators, you will have only one transition diagram. That is what I mean to say here. So now we are going to look at the transition diagram for relational operators. So it has two components that all of us know. One is a circle, another one is edge. Edge and circle. The transition diagram is made up of several edges and several circles. Among all the circle, there are two distinguished circles. One is attached with arrow mark, that is start state. A circle which is labeled with or drawn with double lines, double circle, that is termed as final state. So that is only difference among the set of all circles. But in general, transition diagram consists of several circles and several edges. Among this circle, there are three categories. One is start node or start state, intermediate node, intermediate states, or final states or final node. So that is where the transition process stops, halting is happening only with the stop state, end state. End or stop state is a recognition telling that you need to stop the process. So once if the process reached the final state, no more activity is carried out. So that is the meaning of final state. Let us look at this diagram. There is a start state, there is a state. Since we have several states, so many circles, for the identification purpose, for the recognition purpose, every state is labeled with your state number or state identity. You can have number, alphabet, it doesn't matter. A1, A2, Q1, Q2, Q0, any kind of labeling you can give. It's a kind of labeling. Why we all of us have names? In order to identify. If you say one roll number C6, immediately that signifies I'm talking about roll number C6. So whether name it roll number or your name, the moment I pronounce the name and roll number, what does mean? The entire property related to that person is brought into the picture. So it is for identification, a kind of a social identity. For that only we are naming. Similarly, here so many circles we have. In order to identify which circle we are talking about, where we are focusing, what we are concentrating, whatever in terms of human perspective or computer perspective. So it is labeled with a distinguished identities, that is 0, 1, 2, any order you can have, doesn't matter. I can keep here 0, suddenly I can come here 1, 2, 3, 4, any order, it doesn't matter. Then if at all you are maintaining a logical sequence, that is well and good. Otherwise, it doesn't matter where to where you are going. That exactly we need to translate this diagram in terms of program. We need to write a lex code. That lex code only will makes your computer to perform better, not this diagram. This diagrammatic representation is for human understanding. We need to understand in order to translate or in order to recognize the token. It is for human language. This finite automata itself for the human language. When it comes computer, it is full of coding only, nothing more. Compiler is written with yet another code. Then compiler starts translating your written code into machine level code. So this is the situation or scenario. Now, immediately it sees less than operator, it moves to state number one. After seeing less than operator, if it sees subsequently greater than operator, then it moves to state number three. This is different language. I'm not sure which language I have forgotten. So whenever you see this pair of less than and greater than, this is termed to be not equal to, that is a representation they are keeping. When it comes to C language, not equal to, we write like this, exclamatory mark equal to. Instead of exclamatory mark equal to, they are writing this symbol, no need to worry of, that is the meaning not equal to. Then if it is not less than or equal to, if it is not greater than or whatever, this symbol comes, it is not equal to, the meaning is not equal to. If it is not these all, that is termed as less than. Then if it sees greater than symbol, greater than or equal to. If there is no equal to, it is termed as greater than. then if it sees very first itself, it gets a symbol equal to, it is termed as equal to symbol. This is the transition diagram. It goes from one state to another state. Finally, if you notice, if it reaches the final state, it returns the token identification or token information. Relational operator, it says LE. LE is the recognition information. This particular combination relation relop comma LE is passed on to the parser. Subsequently, less than followed by greater than symbol it sees, then it is termed as not equal to. When this instant comes into the picture, it starts sending the combination, a pair of information, relop. Relop means relational operator, NE, to the parser. Similarly, last category, other. If it is not less than equal to or not this, then anything else sees, it is termed as less than. It is termed as less than. So that is what they are considering in this transition diagram. You can think of, you can design different transition diagram in different approach also, it doesn't matter. Then equal to, relational operator, relop, comma, EQ. Then greater than symbol, greater than followed by equal to occurs, it returns a pair of information, relational operator, comma, greater than. If greater than is not followed by anything else, if it says other, other means greater than followed by space also possible, yet another token is also possible. Because we cannot find out where exactly the token is ending. User may tend to write after exact keyword also, user may tend to write something by mistake also, by typographical error also, or without awareness also. So it needs to scan the next token also. After scanning next token, it needs to take decision whether that particular character belongs to next token, or that particular character belongs to this token, but I need to skip that character temporarily. I need to recognize this as the greater than. That all decision there, it would be taken. Then if user try, for this example, for this situation, I will give you an example. See, int a, for example, instead of int a, user tries to write int a in C language without space. Forgotten, he have forgotten, then he is giving space and the comma, C comma, semicolon, he is giving. What is wrong in it? Int mandatorily need to be followed by space. Instead of that, that guy is trying to write int without space, A he have written. Then what it does is, it will start scanning int, I-N-T, it will start scanning up to T, then other character also it's supposed to read. Whether there is another scenario, I will write here immediately. Int space A comma B comma C. This is very valid statement. Both the scenario, one more character it is mandated to read. Here it's supposed to read A, here it's supposed to read space. One more character it is suggested, advised to read. After reading that character only, it has to take decision. If the user is trying to give space followed by int, it is very fantastic, well and good. Immediately, int is recognized, taken the decision. Int A, how it is scanning, let us say. Int A also, it will be taken as integer. Followed by A comes also, A is striped A, skips, it skips A. That is what we were telling. Auto error mechanism, recovery mechanism in the previous case, panic mode recovery, these all we have seen. Then it skips A. It has the transition diagram only for int. It doesn't have the transition diagram for int A. Then it will try to treat that A into next token. That is why that other is mandatory, because where the particular token is ending, the word is ending, that it's supposed to detect. That is a prime role. So it will go for one character further. One particular character further it will go. That is why, see, if anything starts with less than also, it goes for other character. If it starts with greater than also, it goes for other character. Then equal to, there is no other combination they have mentioned here. So other character, it recognizes relational operator and greater than. Only the greater than. Greater than followed by space or anything else also, it is treated as a greater than. greater than symbol followed by immediately equal to without any space, any other combination, it is treated as greater than. So finally, this is the transition diagram for relational operator. You can have like this for arithmetic operators also. You can have like this for logical operators as well. This all we have seen. Double circle represents accepting state or final state. Now, if we have moved one or more characters too far in finding the token, one stars are drawn. See, what is the meaning? This star is you reach the state after seeing the symbol one or more character. That is the meaning. You reach the, see, look at this carefully. The star, wherever the star has come, no, that particular part I am trying to tell. See this star. I am trying to talk about this star. I need to minute. This star only I am trying to talk. This star. I need to change the color. Yeah, this particular star only I am trying to talk. Similarly, the star is available here as well. So these two stars indicates the particular scanning process started reading more than one character or at least two character in order to reach that state. So whatever the previous states are telling up to that, it is termed as a token. After that, whatever it is scanned, that is not treated as a token. That will be taken into consideration for the next token analysis. That is the reason other symbol has come. Now, imaginary star, that star, what that signifies, indicate where to begin the process, coming from it to indicate where to begin the process, next process. Subsequent to recognizing that less than, subsequent to recognizing that greater than equal to, next where to process. How to load the lexical buffering scheme or how to move the pointer, for that, those all extra characters will be indicating. Whichever it starts reading as a other character, that all other character is for indicating the next token recognition, identification. Now let us see, it has the function relational operator less than. Whatever I articulated is there, that's all. So if you look at, you look at the first character, if it is less than, you look at the next character. If that character is equal to, you return relational operator comma less than to the parser. If instead that character is greater, you return relational operator not equal to. If it is another character, it is written as a relational operator less than. Then it adjusts the input buffer so that you will read this character again, since you have to use it for the current lexeme. You have not used it for the current lexeme. That other one character it is reading now. You please imagine this. This int AB. After int, it will read this character A in this case, wrong case. Then whereas in the right case, it will read space. That space reading, that A reading is mandatorily happening. But that character, whichever it read, is considered for the next token. It needs to take decision where it ends. Then after that, what is available? If it is ending also, not ending also, what to be done? That's why it will start scanning one or more characters after seeking the particular operator also. It will move on. That movement only they are indicating. That the star is termed as imaginary star. So that indicates end of the state. It started reading couple of characters further the token. After recognizing the token also, it starts reading. For example, imagine your exam is over. You have completed data structure. After writing exam, that is a final assessment happening. But beyond that also, you can read that subject for the betterment of your placement or elevation of your knowledge or learning data science field. So that is the indication that whatever you read after exam, that kind of indication is that star. You will read, although you recognized the appropriate token, it will start reading one or more characters after recognizing the particular token. That why it starts to read, it needs to take decision what to be done next. Not only one token, should move on, it should accelerate the further scanning process. Now look at white space, the token is WS, then if the keyword, the token is if, then the token comes, then the token is then else is else. If see, there is no attribute for this all. When the identifier is coming, point to the table entry it gives. When the number is coming, it gives pointer to the table entry. When it, this is holistic picture. White space comes, there is no attribute. If comes, it's a keyword, there is no other attribute. Then comes, it's a keyword, there is no other attribute. Else comes, there is a keyword, it's no other attribute. But identifier comes, collection of identifiers are stored in the symbol table. Then it will give pointer to that symbol table, or it will create a pointer to that symbol table when during the scanning process. So where it is placing that symbol, that address it needs to pass on to the parser. So that is why there is an attribute. See here, attribute. A number comes. You may use lot of numbers, constants. You may tell pi is equal to, you will assign. Then pi is equal to 3.14, you may assign in your program. And you may assign one more constant, int, max mark equal to 100. Because whenever I am evaluating your paper, you should not go more than 100, however you write better. Then if at all I am assessing your paper more than 100, that shows what I am having not full of conscious. So that I can put up a condition. It is like that. So that ceiling number, it will do the entry pointer to the table. All the numbers, whichever you are mentioning, like constants, like initialization with the number x is equal to a, so x is equal to 10, x is equal to y is equal to 200, some kind of assignment you will be giving, initialization, that all those numbers will be stored in constant table or number table. So that pointer is sent as an attribute. When it comes less than operator, LT is sent as attribute. When it comes less than or equal to operator, LE is sent as in as an input to the parser. Equal to or attribute is generated, EQ, this attribute is sent to the parser. If this symbol comes, combination, less than and greater than combination is not equal to, this is sent as input to the parser. When it comes to Pascal, less than and greater than, Fortran also uses less than and greater than symbol, I guess. Not equal to in Fortran is less than and greater than. Whenever you try to write a programming in Fortran, that is scientific programming language, when I started my BE, I started learning, my first language is a Fortran. So in that combination, pair of combination is available, less than and greater than. That's all. These are all the attributes or tokens passed on to the point parser. When it comes if, then, else, white space, there is no attribute is passed on. Now let us move on to recognition of reserved words, identifiers. Only three more transition diagram or four more we will be discussing. That's it. First transition diagram, we started discussion on relational operators. Relational operators are less than, equal to, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, not equal to. These are all the possible relational operators. This is the transition diagram for relational operators. Now we are moving, then we started discussing example for lexeme, which lexeme is categorized into which token, which token will have attribute, which token will not have attribute. This is what the part of discussion. Now we are moving to transition diagram for our recognition of reserved words and identifiers. You can write transition diagram also. Otherwise, it is how we are recognizing reserved words, keywords and identifiers. Now let us look at this diagram. This is the diagram is meant for recognizing keywords begin, end, else, if, then, do, while. This is exactly a transition diagram for Fortran. In the Fortran, we used to write with begin. Instead of flower bracket and all, we used to put begin. So now it starts with the start symbol. The moment it sees the character B, then the transition would be moved on from Q0 to Q1. The moment it sees B, the transition will move on this path. Then subsequently, it will take the transition on E, G, I, N, begin. Then it sends the token. What is the token will be sent? This token will be sent with the number. See, return 2, return 5, return 4, return 1, return 6. Anything you can write return, that's all. Because it's for theoretical point of view, we are writing. after reading n also look at blank or new line, blank or new line. Every time it starts reading blank or new line, say after character nothing else is permitted. It will have either blank or new line in when it comes Python. Sorry, Fortran. When it comes Fortran, either it comes blank or new line. So after begin, it scans one more symbol. That symbol should be blank or new line. Then it reaches the final state. After reaching the final state, it returns one constant value, one number, one integer. It returns return one, return two. You in your exam you can write in any order. No need to by heart that and all. Begin, draw one more state, new line or white space. And that final state you need to reach. In the final state, you should return a token value. That token value is of integer. What is the meaning is, for all the reserved word, it will create a reserved table entry. It will keep a table, reserved word table. In that table, every keyword is attached with one integer value. Because English, that see, although we are discussing natural language processing, machine cannot understand natural language processing. We need to convert it into vectors. We need to convert it into something using corpus dictionary. They will be converting every occurrences or instances of English words in terms of again numerical. Because NLP works with the mathematical complete calculus and complete matrix algebra only, statistics only playing a role. Calculus and statistics only a major role played in natural language processing also. Then it cannot understand the language which is natural language processing means in order to process Telugu language, English language, that is called natural language processing. It cannot do. It needs to be converted. Same philosophy you imagine for compiler also. Compiler cannot understand begin, if, else, for, while, do, these keywords it cannot understand. So that what they will put, every keyword, they will translate it into equivalent integer value. For that integer value, they will be writing a code, what to be done for that. Semantic action they will write. What is the meaning of semantic action? In the previous class I was mentioning, reading any word in English is possible for you. Etymology, you can read. But the moment I say what is the meaning of it, that is called semantic. It is very tough. Unless otherwise you would have learned or come across that word, you cannot answer to me. What is the meaning of etymology? No one can answer. So that is called semantic. Then semantic action time, for that one, it will start doing some manipulations or some task, some necessary execution it will carry out. So you can return one, return two, return three, return four, return five, return six, and so on. Then very first character starts with E, subsequently N comes, it will take this path, end, begin and end. Every Fortran program, we need to write with starting with the keyword begin. When the program ends, we need to write end. There is no flower bracket like in C language, which you write with a flower bracket. So after end also, it starts reading yet another character. That could be blank or new line. Then it reaches either of these one. Then it reaches the final state. It sends the token 2. Then first character is E. Second character is L. L. Then it takes this part. Else. E-L-S-E. Subsequently, blank or rewrite returns 3. Next. If first character is I, next character is if, then it followed by blank or new line returns 3. If the first character is T, subsequent character is H, E, N, then followed by blank or rewrite, returns 4. First character is D, followed by O, followed by blank or new line, returns 6. If the first character is W, then followed by H, I, L, E, Y, followed by blank or new line, it returns 7. So this number, no need to worry. In your examination, you need to write some number. It returns some constant or integer. So that is what you need to remember when it comes to drawing this diagram. Very simple. This topic, if you are thorough on at least a glimpse of finite automata, this topic of discussion is not at all required. Now, let us move on to, this is the diagram for identifier recognition. The title itself I have written so that I didn't use any English. Reserved word and identifiers. When it comes to the identifier, what is identifier? You can write identifier anything. For example, int number 1, you can write number underscore 2, you can write comma, simple a also you can write. So this is called identifier, declaration identifier. Look at this, how I am doing this identifier. Let us consider number 1, very first letter in all the three scenario, number 1, number 2 and number a, in all the three scenarios I am starting with the letter only. If you look at carefully, this is mandatory. By this time you would have come across 4-5 languages. See, every identifier starts with a letter. Yes, mine is right. All the three declared variables are right in my scenario. Subsequently, what it says, infinite number of type, that means looping. Looping means it can occur infinite number of time. Any number of letter or digit can be repeated. Then up to U to 1, up to U to R, it will take this. Now in this scenario, underscore is not given. Then which identifier is wrong? Tell me. Based on this transition diagram, I have declared three variable. Which variable is wrong? Tell me. Am I did justification suitable to the transition diagram? I have written random. Now, which is the variable not recognized by that transition diagram? I am telling that is a transition diagram for recognizing the identifier. But one of the identifier, it will not recognize. What is that? Guys, if you are like this, it is really annoying.
It doesn't recognize number 1.
Number 1, it doesn't recognize. Wrong, think of it once. Please look at the diagram. Look at the carefully, it is wrong. Simple matter. I myself had given you the clue. Number 1, it see, look at letter followed by letter or digit the whole star. So this always this loop is indicates that it is a star, clean star. So letter or digit, see, I am having U, M, B, E, R, 1. So it recognizes digit, na? 1 is digit, no. It recognizes. A is also recognized. It skips this loop. Letter, other, yes, it does the other job. I will tell what is this job. See, coming to this scenario, it will not recognize. Look at this carefully. This number 2 is not recognized because underscore I haven't mentioned. The same will become right. When it will become right? Here if I write using R. 1 minute, I'll correct this diagram for the R. If I write R, 1 minute, the font size I need to reduce. Or I need to increase. Yeah. R followed by underscore. If I write like this, then this transition diagram would become eligible for recognizing which one? Number 2 as well. Could you able to understand what I am trying to tell? Underscore is missing. If underscore is given, then it will recognize this. C4 is joining right now. Almost at the end of the session. He's joining right now. Yeah, there are few comments. Yeah, number 2. D4 is right exactly. I haven't noticed the comment by the time. Number 2 is not recognized because underscore is not defined in this scenario. If I write this diagram like this with R symbol, then my number 2 is right. See, I will write down here. If I write R underscore also, then this transition diagram is the eligible transition diagram to recognize number 2 as well. If I am not writing on that arrow mark R underscore, it is not eligible. Int number 1, A only eligible for recognition. That's it. Hope so you all would be understanding. Now it choice is yours. In your examination, you will write with underscore, without underscore. That is your choice. I am explaining in both way. Underscore, when we were doing fortran, no, there is no underscore. These all diagrams people have written, compiler design book, those days, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, they have written. By that time, whatever the language was there, that language they were telling. Now, why I am including underscore? The modern language permits underscore. So I have given you diagram for modern language also. Now choice is yours. Could you get my point now what I'm speaking? Pavan, is it clear now?
Pavan, yes,
are you there? Yeah, okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Now, the question remains, how do we distinguish identifiers and keywords in the transition diagram? What is get token? What is install ID? See, here I have written, no, get token, install ID. We are touching upon this. We understood up to this. What is other? See, look at every character, every variable when I read, followed by something else is there. After that only I will come to know whether I completed scanning the identifier or not. I need to go one step at least further. That is why we are using all the time other in the transition diagram before reaching the final state or exiting from the transition diagram. So it says, yes, we are successfully done. This star indicates how further the lexer buffer need to load, how it needs to proceed. The character unnecessarily which is red, that other edge is there, no? Upon that other edge, the character is unnecessarily red. So that all unnecessary character have not considered in the present lexem, those characters are need to be considered in the next lexem. That all the indication, that all the verbal articulation, what I am doing is denoted by star. When it comes coding, that star need to be written by some coding. Some if decision, switch statement, alternative, some kind of decisions need to be taken or some kind of direction need to be given. So that is the meaning of that star. Now, what is get token? What is install ID? We are going to discuss. Install ID is to install, checks if the lexeme is already in the table. What is the table? Symbol table. I will rewrite. I haven't loaded it. Symbol table. It first checks for whether that identifier is available in the symbol table already. If it is available, what it does? Multiple declaration, that warning it will try to give. You will tend to declare int A also. Unconsciously, you will tend to declare float A also. This all happened with me also happened, with you also would have happened. So that indication is verified here itself. With the lexical phase itself, it is been identified. If that lexeme is already found in the symbol table, it gives error. If it is not found in the symbol table, it installs. What is the meaning of install? It will create a pointer, then it will place that symbol in the symbol table and all its associated properties. Already mentioned, symbol table will have collection of identifiers. Along with that, it will have type, size, scope, value, associated value. At that particular point of time, what is the value will be available. So A, the moment it says A, in the beginning of the program, it may have garbage value. If it is of local variable, if you say int A, it is a local variable. Then the initial value would become garbage value. So whatever the garbage value, it will be waiting. Until user tries to disturb or reassign some value, it will be with garbage value only. So that is fine. Now, it starts placing that entry into the symbol table. If it is not present, installed, then pointer to entry is returned in either case. Whether it is multiple entry or single entry also, it will return the pointer, it seems. Where exactly that identifier or variable is available, that address is passed on to the parser for the further references. Parser, what it does? It starts attaching the value to the variable, then it further it gives to semantic phase for the evaluation. The moment the compiler reaches the semantic phase, automatically partial evaluation happens. So now what is the combination we are trying to tell? Checks for the lexeme already available in the symbol table. If it is not present, the lexeme is installed. Installation means don't think in different way. It creates a pointer in the symbol table. Then after creating the pointer, it sends the pointer value and to the parser and returns. Get token, what is the meaning? Examines the lexeme, returns the token name, either ID or name corresponding to a reserved keyword. If it is already existing or if it is not existing, get token. Finally, after installation, get token only will get the exact pointer value. If it is keyword also, looking at the keyword table, it will get to know the exact name of the or label of the keyword through get token. There are two functions always involved. One is install function, that is to create a pointer or create a reservoir for the variable storage into the symbol table. The other one is get token. Get token will start getting the exact entry detail. If it is keyword, it will get the token value. If it is variable, it gets the pointer value. That's all. That is a get token and install ID. Install ID means installing identifier. That's all. Now we are going for recognizing white space. Very simple. Look at start. Delimiter, n number of time. See, if it wants to recognize the space between line and line, what will happen? It will keep on delimiter until getting the first character. It skips, it goes. For example, when it happens int, there is no condition. I can give space like this, then I can declare number 1, comma number 2. By unconsciously, you may press that space also. It doesn't matter. Int, it will not scold you. Hey, come on guy, you have given this much space, it is not at all possible for me to understand. It should not give. If that particular situation or the context is permitted to have one space, it can have n number of space. There is no more restriction for space alone. Please be very careful. You can try with any language, Python, C, Java also. Int followed by space is permitted by the compiler. You can have several number of spaces. That is why it says skipping. In that case, it needs to keep on skipping. Where this guy is starting, what this guy does, it needs to think and make strain itself. So that is this is the diagram for recognizing the white space. That's all. Now recognizing the number. With that, we are going to conclude. This is the last diagram. Recognizing the number. Digit we are defining, it's a range of information from 0 to 9. Whatever comes with 0 to 9 only, you and myself will call digit. Then what is digits? Digits equal to digits plus. Yeah, minimum 1 it should occur. That is why this plus we are talking. The moment this is cleansed positive star, already we discussed a lot on it. What is the meaning of plus? The moment you see plus, that seems minimum one instance, one occurrence to infinite number of instance or multiple number of instance. So that plus number, what is the meaning of number? Digits followed by, this is optional. See, question mark is given. Question mark is given means optional. Then dot digits followed by E, exponent, that representation, E symbol, scientific symbol, followed by plus or minus question mark. This is also optional. Digits question mark. This component is optional. When you will say minimum digit, digits digit plus. For this, we are going to look at the transition diagram. Look at this digit. Directly, you can jump to the final state. If at all recognizing single digit, look at the other scenario. L120 or I2 20. This I2 20 combination, if you take, it will recognize single digit number. If you take the combination I2, I3 and 20, it will recognize multiple combination. I'll write down here. See, I2, 20, if you take, it will recognize the digits, all the single digits. 0, it will recognize 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are all the single digit it will recognize. If I take the combination I1, I3, 20, then it will recognize any digit of multiple digit combination. Multiple digits means what? Two digit number also. Multiple digits, it will recognize. For example, it can recognize 220 also, 230 also, 3, 4, 5, 6 also, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 also. This kind of digits it can recognize. This is for integer recognizer. these two combination I2, I3 and 20 combination is for integer recognition. Now, for the float recognition, after this, you need to come to the state I4. I1, comma, I3, comma, I4 for the float. You need to come mandatorily to this state. This is for integer recognition. All in one diagram. Multiple final state always will give you multiple representation. Now we are going for float recognition. In the float recognition, it needs to take this path. See, after reaching I4, you must go to I5 at least to to recognize one digit, I5. Now, after I5, you need to reach 22. This combination is to recognize any number of digits. It could be one or multiple digits. Followed by single digit. What can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, R. This is the combination. Now, for the float recognition itself, what else it can do? After this multiple digit recognition, then it can come back to 21. Sorry, it is 21, not 22. Here itself 21. Another combination is, combinations are this. Before 21, it should go to 15. Already 15 is there. Yeah, 15, multiple time it will repeat. Now this is for multiple digit. Any number of digits followed by dot, followed by any number of digits. This is a combination it recognizes. In the exam also you can write nothing wrong in it. Now come back to, then if it is represented by exponential symbol, exponential component, then E, mandatory to read. Then just reading this, never it will be right. The moment you say exponential, you need to mandatorily to say it is plus or minus. Then it is mandatory to say for you digit. See, it comes loop. Digit here followed by, the here also one digit will come. Sorry, it is not available. You need to assume here digit. Then finally other. Otherwise I will draw it digit. This arrow mark need to be filled with digit. So this is the transition diagram in order to recognize the scientific number with all the possible combinations, with exponential symbol, with the sign, etc., etc. With that, if you have any doubts, you can keep discussing. Guys, if you have doubts, you can keep discussing.